welcome back to The Verdict. Well, a lot has been spoken of about the conduct of security agencies for these elections, how we're told a lot depends on what they do for these elections. Well, now we've been joined by Mr. Dennis Amakre, who is a former deputy director with the SSS. He joins us from our studios here in Lagos. And then we've got Mr. Lawrence Alobi, former commissioner of police in the FCT, joining us from the FCT as well. Gentlemen, thank you both for coming on today. Well, Mr. Amakre, I know it may be your former constituency, but give us your impressions how this has panned out in terms of how they've conducted themselves. Yes, we saw what transpired in the presidential and national assembly elections. What about this day, today? What did you see?
I think we have not even learned from the presidential election, the happenings there. Because those security threats that actually happened in the presidential are repeating themselves again. Right now, we still have ballot papers being burnt in Akwa Ibom State recently, today. And I think...
Today?
Yeah, today.
River State. Today.
I don't know about the river. I know about the River State. There was a situation where somebody tried to pick a ballot box and the mob descended on him, you know. And a lot of things are happening, especially in the southern part of the country. And it's worrisome because elections are not supposed to be like this. You know?
But why do you think this is the case?
I think there are parochial interests, personality clashes, and people actually misunderstanding what the election process is supposed to be. You know, like I mentioned earlier or before, that politicians going into elections is to seek, apply to do a job for the public. The applicant cannot be fighting himself to do the job. It is the public that will decide, okay, yes, you are qualified, you are not qualified, but here we are killing ourselves to go in there and take the job. And then, of course, we know when they get in there, they forget the masses that are killing themselves about it right now.
Have you heard of some of those reports that emanated from River State, for instance, where our correspondent Emmanuel Ray is still waiting on to confirm from the police authorities, relevant security agencies deployed for these elections? You have been, at least you still get some insider information. Did you get any of those information about the kind of violence that is taking place there today?
Oh, well, this thing has been on. In fact, you will know that the violence is going to take place today because, you know, some top government officials have been making incendiary statements, and on both sides. And, you know, the outcomes are going to be very, very dangerous for people, especially the innocent Nigerian that does not really know the underworkings of what is going on. Because this election has been one of the most violent we have in this country. And I think the security agencies have to really play it again, because their own role in this election is to create security for everybody. But I think one way or the other, sometimes even some of them have been compromised into it, whereby we are having deaths, never as before, and it's not acceptable.
On the one hand is heavy security. On the other hand is what you are also talking about.
You know, I don't know what you call heavy security. You know, when people...
It's the military presence.
See military, like I said earlier, military is not supposed to be there. You know, we're not supposed to have military
elections. All of that is playing out towards one thing in particular, which is the fact that we have far less voter turnout now as before.
And yes.
That should give one some concern.
A lot of voter apathy. And, you know, first of all, the
postponement. Is that the result of the insecurity or too much of that?
Insecurity. Because when you have soldiers, you know, driving around in their trucks, and then of course they are aware that some people have been killed. I lost a niece, you know, in Port Harcourt, in Degema local government. You know, so People like that, I talk to many people who are saying that I'm not going out, I don't want to die, because those people don't need to die. And this particular person was an INEC staff. You know, so if INEC staff can be killed, what do you expect? You know, so there is this apathy that makes people not to even go out, they stay in their houses. And it's run across the country. You can see that the voter turnout is very, very low all around.
Yes, sir. Let's take this to Mr. Alobi.
Yes, Mr. Alobi, the police is supposed to be the lead agency in this election. From all that you have seen, and with all of the collaboration that is supposed to have played out with other security agencies, how do you see the police faring so far?
Yeah, thank you very much. I think the police have been doing excellently very well. They are really the lead agency, and they are in terms of internal security, they are the principal law enforcement agency, and they are actually been carrying that role effectively throughout the election, both particularly the presidential and national assembly elections. And this particular one, they have deployed their men. Men have been given rules of engagement, code of conduct, and all the areas that need to be covered have been covered. And I think they are doing very well. So the point is that we seem to overemphasize on few lapses here and there. We don't look at the positive aspect of what people are doing. We have to appreciate our services, security services, the police, and others who are doing their best to give up, make sure that we have a free, credible, and fair election. But not also looking at some minor lapses here and there. The police have done very well. Even the pessimists attested to the fact that the presidential election and national assembly election, they did very well. And I'm sure that they will do the same, because the IG, Damu, has always emphasized on the issue of professionalism, and that they should be apolitical, they should not be partisan. And that those principles have been adhered based on the fact that before the elections commenced, there was a training, capacity building training for all officers and men of the Nigerian police force in all the 12 zones of the Federation. So that training at least enhanced their capacity and understanding of the Obeda Offence in the Electoral Act, and what they should do, what should be their role. And I think they've done well. We shouldn't always think of looking at fault. They should look at the positive aspect of what people are doing. That will give them, that will motivate them and also encourage people. All right, and again, we tend to forget that the Nigerian citizens have a role to play in maintaining law and order.
All right, Mr. Alobi, we will come to you in a moment, so you can continue your line of thought, and perhaps Hayo may have a follow-up question for you as well. But we also need to get to the field. Correspondent Larry Lasisi is in Kwara. Remember, it's one of the states to watch. We're keeping an eye there. He's our eye on the ground, as a matter of fact. Larry, what do you see?
Well, we're waiting to get Larry. Mr. Alobi talked about the few lapses, you know, but these few lapses have, of the police, you know, he talked about them, but these few lapses have played a significant role in voter turnout, lower voter turnout than 2 weeks ago. That's something that should give anyone concern.
Yeah, it's cause and effect, you know, cause and effect. My dear friend Lawrence had said that there are few lapses. You cannot call it few lapses when I hope he didn't lose a close relative. If you lose a close relative, it will not be few to you anymore. A single shot, you know, which is fired anywhere will stop anything going on.
Okay, let's quickly go. Okay, I think we are quick to get to. Okay, so these few lapses now. Just as you have said, many people would be afraid to even step out of their homes. But how credible would that make this election?
Well, the thing is that there is no two-third rule to the election. It's a majority rule. So even if it is 10 people that came out and they voted, the majority will win. So
we'll have to get back to you on that, because there is something that INEC said that is different.